Hi students, so in this video we are going to discuss about the energy stored in capacitors. So here is a capacitor whose capacitance is C and it is initially uncharged. So initial charge on the capacitor is zero, right? And it is connected to a battery of V potential difference. Now if we connect it, and as soon as we on the circuit, immediately charge will start flowing from this positive terminal, and gradually on this plate, left side plate, there will be a positive charge, and on the negative side there will be a negative charge. So let's assume that at time t the charge on the plate is Q. Charge on any of the plate on the capacitor is Q, right? So at that point the potential difference on the capacitor, so potential difference across the capacitor that will be Q equals to CV, so V will be Q divided by C. Okay, so for this capacitor, capacitance is constant but charge is gradually increasing, that's why this potential difference will also increase. Now let's say this charge Q is there and minus Q is there, and I want to increase this charge by dQ. So what I am doing in the process of increasing the charge, I am taking out positive plus Q charge from this plate and bringing on this plate, right? So let's assume for calculation that I am bringing a minute quantity of charge dQ from negative plate and I am bringing on the positive plate. So tell me, what will be the work done? Work done in this process? Work done on charge dQ? dQ, that will be potential difference at that point multiplied by dQ. As we know, dW is equals to V multiplied by Q. Okay, that formula we have learnt in the electrostat, Q multiplied by del V. This is the work done if you want to bring a charge from del V potential difference. Now if I want to calculate total work, so total work will be the integration of this work dW, right? So W is equal to integration of dW, and that will be V multiplied by dQ integration, and dQ is changing from initial charge 0 to the final charge, let's assume capital Q. Now this V and Q, they are different variables, so I want to have same variable for the integration. So that's why I will replace this V potential difference bit with Q by C. So from here I can write down W is equals to Q by C multiplied by dQ integration from 0 to Q. Okay, so when we integrate, 1 by C is constant, and the integration of Q is Q square divided by 2, and the limit for this integration is from 0 to capital Q. Okay, if we place the limit, we will get this formula, W equals to Q square divided by 2C. Okay, if we want the other format, we can also write this Q equals to CV, and from there we can calculate this formula, half CV square, which is similar to something half MV square, right? And we can also write down this C equals to QV, and from there we can also write down this formula, C equals to Q divided by V, so it will be half QV. Okay, so this is the formula of energy stored in the capacitor. So now think about it, what will be the work done by this battery? Work done by this battery will be, we know that work done is Q multiplied by the potential difference. So here the potential difference is constant, so that's why work done by battery, here you need to look at, this is important, work done by battery So that will be the potential difference that is constant multiplied by dq. We are bringing the charge dq, so that is V multiplied by dq. But here we need to remember, keep in mind, V is constant. So if we integrate, so then the dq integration is q, so that's why the work done by battery is q multiplied by V, and where V is the potential difference of battery. So see, work done by battery is qv, and the energy stored, this is energy stored in the battery, is half qv. It means half energy is lost in the form of heat. Okay, so heat loss, what is the heat loss? Heat loss here, it will be the work done by battery minus energy stored, and that is half qv. So in this process, exactly half of the energy will be stored on the capacitor, and exactly half of the energy will be lost in the form of heat losses. Okay, so thank you very much.